Hello everybody, today we're testing the Kenny hack on a piece of slate. First half will be running over, has no treatment on it, just bare slate cleaned away with slope and water. The other half is treated with a couple coats of 50% stain. Gonna see just if this helps benefit anything on slate or not. Gonna be running at 2,000 millimeters per minute, 75% power, 0.15 line resolution. Still just doing a grayscale. Let's see how it comes out. So with no treatment, it is cutting in. Generally with slate, it works to put a pre-coat of like a gloss urethane or a flat urethane or flat black paint also works. If you pre-coat it with that, you can get good results. So right now, even at 2000, the grayscale is cutting in about 50% of the way. It's probably going a little too fast or needs a little bit more power to really do photo quality. Could definitely do maybe a silhouette at this speed and power. Let's try the 50% Kenny hack treated side and see how it does. Does appear to be cutting in a little bit further, getting a little more of the gradation to show up. Going to get a few more passes in, so we got a little more to test with. See how it does. I'd say that speed and power right there would be pretty good for photo quality work, doing 2,000 millimeters a minute. It appears it's getting some gradation all the way down to the end. Not a bad first test run. Let's stop it right there. So as you see, side by side, the Kenny hack treatment definitely gets a little more of the burn in. Little bit longer gradation. I said right there, it'd probably be a pretty good speed and power for doing photo quality work. I'll do another test side by side with treating one half with gloss and one side with the Kenny hack solution and see if it does better or worse than what normally you'd use on slate. So for this test, I'm using the same tile I had before. This time I coated the outside edges with a Rust-Oleum 2X Ultra Cover Matte Clear. Applied a little bit to the side that has no treatment previously, and then a little strip of this stuff over the top of my Kenny hack solution. And we'll see how it reacts with the combination of them two. Same settings. Still 2,000, 75%, 0.15 line spacing. Let's see how this does. Definitely getting an improved gradation on the slate with just the Rust-Oleum applied to it. This is something I've used before to cut photos into slate. It does work very well. Still usually you're kind of running around this 2,000 millimeter speed, which for diodes is kind of average. That's kind of where you do a lot of your work at. Hoping to maybe see if this Kenny hack will allow us to speed that rate up a little bit. Maybe get it up to 3,000 or 4,000 and still get good quality. And we'll see what happens. We'll move it over to the side that has both the Kenny hack solution and the Rust-Oleum. Honeycomb bed was kind of hitting on the rail, so I had to move it over. Stop it and see what we got. Okay, so this is a side with just no Kenny hack solution on it. You can see the Rust-Oleum made about twice the length of gradation burn in. It works really well for a pre-coat for engraving on slate. It's kind of something a lot of people use. Nothing really new with that. You can see mine with just the Kenny hack pre-treatment on this first burn is getting pretty close to what you get with the Rust-Oleum, but without adding even this matte finish adds a lot of glare to the Rust-Oleum. Which when you do photo quality work, that glare can kind of cut down on the finer details that you can see, but it still works very well. When you look, come down to the Kenny hack treatment with the Rust-Oleum, it doesn't quite have as much glare as what just the plain Rust-Oleum has. So you get maybe get a little more of the fine detail. And it's a pretty close toss-up on which one is burning a longer gradation. I'd probably have to get a tape measure out to give an exact measurement of how much I can measure. Initial, I'd have to say with my undertreatment, that Kenny hack undertreatment, it's doing a little bit better. And I like how it doesn't have such a reflective glare to it that you might be able to see some finer detail. I'll have to burn some photo images on here, see how it does, see which one I like better. We'll see how what happens from there. All right, thank you. So here's a side-by-side. On the left is a piece of slate just covered with Rust-Oleum 2X matte finish. Clear. On the right is the Kenny hack as a subcoat at 50% dilution, and then with a layer of the Rust-Oleum matte clear coat over the top of it. From a distance, the matte finish looks like it's coming out a little wider than the one that has the Kenny hack under it. But if you look at, get it closer, it's kind of hard to see. The one that just has a matte finish is a little more granular looking. It's a little coarser. It's not quite as smooth finish when you compare it to the one that has the Kenny hack in it. This one's coming out a lot smoother of a burn, kind of, I guess you'd call it. It's just a little more of a consistent shade. Gonna apply another layer of clear coat over it, of matte finish, just to act as a sealer, kind of give it some protection, and we'll see how that affects it. So this is what they look like after they've been had a second coat of clear matte put back over the top of it. It's a problem I found with Slate. If you try to put a second clear coat over it to kind of put a protective seal, it really drowns out the engraved effect. It looks way better before you put a second coat on. So you kind of got to take risk versus reward. You know, it's probably better to not put a second coat on over the top and just hope that they don't get chipped or flaked when people are using these as coasters. They're going to get beat up. I do think they look better without putting a second coat on. But after the second coat, the one that is just has matte on it and a second coat of matte, a lot of the white, how clear and white it was before, a lot of that has disappeared. If you get straight on with it, the reflection, it pretty much about disappears now. The one with the Kenny hack, I'd say it maintained its color a little better. Doesn't have as much glare. It seems like putting that Kenny hack treatment on the bottom, kind of even with the matte finish, it helps it not reflect so much and it makes it easier to see. I still think it looked better before the second coat, but that's why we do demos, is to see what works and what doesn't. So far, I still say the Kenny hack. I think I'll definitely use it on any of the Slate pieces I do from now on. I think it does give a slight performance enhancement just for making it burn more evenly. But I'll do some more test pieces and see how it comes out. All right, thank you for watching. Please like, subscribe, and share. So here we got a side-by-side on Slate. Again, this time the one on the left was clear-coated first with a gloss Rust-Oleum 2X clear finish gloss. And then it was lasered, and then had another coat of gloss put over the top. As you can see, when you put that gloss over the top, all the reflected light hides a lot of the details. I do think this one on the right that has the Kenny hack applied to the undercoat, and then a thin layer of flat, clear Rust-Oleum 2X applied to it. I've only done a few Slate pieces, but I don't think I can get that to burn any better. That was at 2500 millimeters per minute, 80% power, 0.11 line resolution. So that's, I don't think I'm going to get much better settings than that. I will apply, even though I know it's going to kind of ruin it, I'm going to apply a coat of matte over the one on the right, so we can kind of do a side-by-side comparison again with the one that had the gloss and just see which looks better, gloss or matte finish. And we'll try to see how much detail is lost in the piece when you apply that overcoat. As you can see, this is on the back side of a coaster. Those are the rubber feet that I took off. Really fine detail in there. That's as good as the photo was. If the photo would have had more detail, this would have had more detail. So here they are again, side by side. This time the one on the right that has the Kenny Hack undercoat with a flat clear coat over the top of that, then laser engraved, and then had another layer of flat clear coat or matte finish applied to it. You can see, compared to the one with the gloss finish, you just don't get as much reflection off of it, so the image stays a little clearer. You can still see when you compare before to how much of the fine detail you could see in it. When you apply that second coat, you kind of lose some of the really finer shading details. So it's kind of questionable whether you really want to put another coat on after this. I mean, yes, it kind of seals it and might protect it a little bit, but you also lose some photo quality of it. That's kind of a choice you'll have to make with whatever piece you're doing. Hope you found all this stuff interesting and useful. Please like, subscribe, share. How we get the laser community better is by sharing our information. Thank you.